Question 13. What is the main difference between ALE IDOC and BAPI? Answer. ALE IDOCs are used for asynchronous information interchange, while BAPIs are used for synchronous information interchange. Question 14. Without using the distribution model, can we send data from one system to another system by using ALE? Answer. No, we can't send, because whenever we try to send an IDOC, it checks with distribution model and is there any filtering is defined or not. If it is defined, then checks with filter data and then it checks with receiver and message type. Question 15. How to send the IDOC to multiple subsystems? Answer. If you are sending one IDOC is to more systems, you are create one sender logical system and more receive logical systems in T.code is sale, then you are sending in T.code BD64. Question 16. What is the main difference between interfaces and decks? I think both are cross applications, right? What is the exclusive difference? Answer. According to my knowledge in SAP XI, we have so many kinds of control levels to process the message. For instance, I will discuss on few points, like here using XI, we can communicate with the SAP or non-SAP at sender side or receiver side. XI supports both synchronous and asynchronous communications. In XI, we can find the status of the message where it is during the process of message processing. We have so many kinds of monitoring techniques. Here we can have n number of senders and n number of receivers based on your requirement. It supports to process multiple messages at a time from different senders to multiple receivers. So I feel we can't perform all these things in interfaces. That is the reason XI come into picture. Question 17. When IDOC is created, in which table it's stored? Answer. EDIDD to store data records. EDIDC to store control information. EDIDS to store status of IDOC. Question 18. How to debug an IDOC? Answer. For outbound, we can send through program or function module, but inbound IDOC only through function module. So it depends whether it is outbound or inbound. Then we will debug. Question 19. While sending IDOC from receiver side, I got MSG tie 3 and 12, but in receiver side while executing WE02, I'm getting the error no IDOCs selected. Instead of getting MSG type 53, I am simply sending a material from one client to another client. Answer. The very first setting you need to check is in distribution model if the message type is configured for given sending receiving system combination. If this is correct and partner profile is wrong, you will get an IDOC stuck in 56 status on inbound. You can also check in WE09 with giving more details like segment name related to MRA table and the corresponding material no in the field for selection with MADNR. Question 20. How the data is coming from third-party system to SAP system? Answer. Data from third-party can come from middleware tools like Mercator. Also, data can from third-party from email or fax also. This can be done by integration mail system with SAP inbox. The usual connection for middleware tool can be type 4 TCP IP depending upon the setting of your gateway server properties. One can integrate SAP with other party middleware systems. Question 21. Where to see IDOC in inbound side, whether it is received in receiver system or not? Answer. By executing conversion program RBDMOIND. Execute RBDMOIND in outbound program. If the status code is converting into 3 to 12, then we can confirm the IDOC received successfully. Question 22. Suppose there is one sender and we have three receivers. While generating an IDOC, will it generate three IDOCs for three receivers? Explain in detail how the flow goes from outbound to inbound systems. Answer. In sale, we maintain the send or as well as three receivers. How many receivers to send the same IDOC and assign the send or in send or system as well as assign receivers in receivers system. Sale assignment three receivers. Maintain the RFC destination on send or side and all receiver side also SM59. Maintain the port for send or and three receivers. Maintain the send or and all receivers for a same message type in distribution model BD64. Maintain the partner profiles for send or and all receiver side also WE20. Execute the outbound program IDOC generation like BD12 for DEBMAS message type. Check out the status using WE02 or WE05. Question 23. Can we attach more than one message with one IDOC? Answer. Yes, we can attach more than one message types to one IDOC. For example, send or wants the records on both material and purchase at same time, then we need to add two message types to one IDOC. Question 24. Which type of work process can execute only once in R3 system? SAP. Answer. Dialogue work processor.